In this video, we can discuss about anaerobic culture methods. Before going to the anaerobic culture methods, let's have an idea about pure culture. Pure culture is a population of cell arising from a single cell, and it will help us to characterize the individual species. And there are two type of method for cultures. First one is aerobic cultural method, which are used to culture aerobic microorganism in the presence of oxygen. Aerobic cultural methods to culture anaerobic microorganism in the absence of oxygen. In last video, we had discussed about aerobic cultural methods in detail. Now we will discuss about anaerobic cultural methods in detail. Now, what is anaerobic cultural methods? These are the methods which are used to culture anaerobic microorganism. What is anaerobic microorganism? These are the bacteria which will differ in their requirement and sensitivity towards the oxygen. Now, what are the different type of anaerobic microorganism? There are aerotolerant or strict anaerobes. What is aerotolerance? These are the microorganism which can equally grow in aerobic as well as anaerobic microorganism in some extent. Example are Clostridium histolyticum, and strict anaerobes which will die in presence of oxygen, and it can be grown only in the absence of oxygen. Example is Clostridium tetani. Now let's see what are the different methods for anaerobiosis or anaerobic cultural methods. There are five methods. First one is production of vacuum. Second one is displacement of oxygen with other gases. There are two methods for that: candle jar method and anaerobic chamber. Then third method is chemical method. In that we can use alkaline pyrogallol by using pyrogallic acid and sodium hydroxide, and Rosenthal method by using chromium as well as sulfuric acid. Then McIndoe's field anaerobic jar and gas bag. And fourth method is biological method, and fifth one is reduction of oxygen. Now let's discuss each method in detail. First one is production of vacuum. In this method, we can use a vacuum desiccator to incubate anaerobic cultures by using some desiccants like silica. But this method is not used nowadays because of so many disadvantages, like it is unsatisfactory because always some oxygen will be left behind inside the vacuum, and fluid culture may boil over and the media may get detached from the plate in vacuum produced by a desiccator. Now coming to the second method, displacement of oxygen with other gases. As the name indicate, we will displace the oxygen with other gases like hydrogen, nitrogen, helium or carbon dioxide. And this can be done by two methods: candle jar method and anaerobic chamber method. Now let's see what is candle jar method. It is an old and conventional method in which we will place the inoculated culture of anaerobic microorganism inside a bottle, and we will keep a candle lighted inside the bottle. So what will happen? Till the oxygen remain, light will goes on, and whenever the oxygen is finished, the light will off. And this is used to culture some bacteria like Neisseria gonorrhea, but these also have some disadvantages. Always some oxygen will be left behind inside the bottle. Also, it will provide a concentration of carbon dioxide, and which will stimulate the growth of some other bacteria. So that is the candle jar method. Now coming to the second method of displacement of oxygen with other gases by using anaerobic chamber. It is a conventional method. In this, we will use a plastic anaerobic glove box, which can be sealed in atmosphere of hydrogen, carbon dioxide or nitrogen. Now, culture media are placed in the chamber by means of an airlock, which can be evacuated and refilled with the nitrogen or other gases. Then oxygen in this media can be slowly removed by reacting with hydrogen to form water using any substances like palladium catalyst. So after making the chamber oxygen free, the media are inoculated within the chamber and incubated. So that is the anaerobic chamber. This is an picture of anaerobic chamber. There is a valve and is an airlock door which can be opened, and we can place the inoculated culture of anaerobic microorganism inside that one, and we can evacuate the oxygen as well as we can refill with other gases. After the complete removal of oxygen, we can inoculate the culture. Coming to the third method, chemical method. By using some chemicals, we can remove the oxygen inside. There are four methods: alkaline pyrocalol method, Rosenthal method, McIntosh field jar, and gas bag. Now let's see what is alkaline pyrocalol method. So by using alkaline pyrocalol, which can absorb oxygen by reacting the pyrogallic acid with sodium hydroxide in a large test tube placed inside a airtight jar, will provide anaerobiosis. A small amount of carbon monoxide is formed during this process, and which may inhibit the growth of some bacteria. And this is mainly used to culture of single tube as well as plate culture. Now second method is Rosenthal method, in which we can use chromium and sulfuric acid or chromium with yellow phosphorus. This is also used for single tube or plate culture of anaerobic microorganism. Now third one is most important method is McIntosh field anaerobic jar. This is an most reliable and widely used method. And in this we will discuss the construction, working and advantages and disadvantages of McIntosh field jar. Now first we can discuss what is the construction of a McIntosh jar. It consists of a metal or glass jar with a metal lid which can be clamped airtight, and there are two tubes on the lid, one for inlet as well as second for gas outlet. And there are two terminals on the lid which can be connected to electric supply. And under the lid, there is a small grooved porosin spool wrapped with a layer of palladinized asbestos. So this is a picture which represents McIntosh field jar, a glass or metal jar with a metal lid which can be clamped tight, and there is a two out gas inlet and gas outlet, and there is an electrodes, and there is a catalyst, palladinized catalyst. Now coming to the working of McIntosh field jar, the inoculated plate are placed inside the jar and lid are clamped airtight. Then the outlet tube is connected to the vacuum, and the air inside the jar is evacuated. And after the evacuation, outlet is closed and inlet tube is connected to the hydrogen supply to fill hydrogen. After filling of hydrogen, the electric terminal are connected to the current supply. Then palladinized asbestos will be getting heated, and which will act as a catalyst for the combination of hydrogen with the residual oxygen to form water present in the jar. Now let's see what are the advantages. Will ensure complete anaerobiosis, but there is a disadvantage, like there is a risk of explosion which will occur rarely, and this can be modified by modifying the catalyst. Instead of palladinized asbestos, we can use alumina pellet coated with the palladium, which is suspended from the lid of jar in a coarse sachet, which act as a catalyst as long as it is dry. So that is the McIntosh field jar. Now coming to the fourth method, gas pack method. This is a method of choice for preparing anaerobic jar, and it is available commercially as disposable envelope. And this envelope containing pellets of sodium borohydrate, cobalt chloride, citric acid and sodium bicarbonate. So these chemicals will generate hydrogen and carbon dioxide on addition of water by reacting with the oxygen inside the jar. Now advantages is it is very simple and effective, and we can eliminate the need of drawing of vacuum and adding of hydrogen. So it is a simple step, but we have to just keep this envelope inside an anaerobic jar, and we have to add water to that envelope. That is enough for the gas pack. Now let's see what is the working of gas bag. The inoculated plates are kept inside the jar, and gas bag envelope after adding the water is placed inside the jar, and the lid screw is tightened, and the cold catalyst in the envelope causes the combination of liberated hydrogen as well as carbon dioxide to remove the oxygen, and it will result in anaerobic environment. We can also use an indicator, reduced methylene blue. It will give a colorless in anaerobic condition and blue color on exposure to the oxygen. So that is the gas pack method. So this is a picture which represents the gas bag. We can keep the gas bag envelope which containing sodium bicarbonate and sodium borohydrate by adding water inside an anaerobic jar, and we can keep the petri plate which is inoculated with anaerobic microorganism, and we can kept the screw tightened. It will produce the anaerobiosis. Now fourth method is biological method. In this, absorption of oxygen from closed system is by incubation along with the aerobic bacteria, as well as by using germinating seeds or chopped vegetables. And the disadvantage is this is slow and ineffective. Practically, it will not produce anaerobiosis. Now, fifth method is reduction of oxygen, and this can be done by different method. First one is by using reducing agent. So reduction of oxygen can be done by reducing agents like 1% glucose or 0.1% thioglycolate or 0.1% ascorbic acid or 0.05% cysteine. And also can be done by adding a piece of red hot metallic iron to the broth prepared, and then by adding sterile Vaseline on the surface of the prepared broth also can be used for the reduction of oxygen. Now also by broth containing animal tissue such as rabbit, kidney, spleen, testis or heart, like in Smith Noshi medium, which will support the growth of many anaerobic microorganisms. Now second method is by using thioglycolate broth. So by introducing reducing agent like sodium thioglycolate, which can remove the oxygen from the liquid medium. Here we can use a methylene blue or rasa serine dye as an indicator. So if oxygen is absent, that means in a reduced state it will produce colorless. If when oxygen is present, that means in oxidized state, it will produce a color, blue for methylene blue and pink for rasa serine. And the rasa serine are most often used due to its less inhibitory effect than the methylene blue. This is a pictorial representation of the growth of anaerobic microorganism in thioglycolate broth method. The obligative aerobes will grow only on the top of the media, and microphylls which need less oxygen content will just beneath the surface. Facultative aerobe will grow both surface as well as inside the media, and aerotolerant to some extent it will grow growth on both aerobic and anaerobic condition, and obligative anaerobe only will grow inside the culture media or bottom of the fluid thioglycolate broth. Now coming to third method, Robertson cooked meat media or fluid media. It is a fat free minced cooked meat in broth with a layer of sterile Vaseline over it, and it permits the growth of even strict anaerobic microorganism which indicate the saccharolytic as well as proteolytic activity by meat, and it can be identified by turning red or black respectively. The saccharolytic activity can be indicated by red, as well as proteolytic activity can be indicated by black. So last method is Brewer anaerobic cultural plate method. Brewer anaerobic cultural plate is an specially designed petri dish cover to use with an anaerobic medium without using anaerobic jar. The cover is provided with a circular ridge that rests on the medium, providing very rare space above the medium. Anaerobic condition in the space result from the presence of reducing agent in the medium. After streaking on a agar surface, the conventional petri dish cover is replaced by sterile Brewer cover, and the medium should be deep enough so that the Brewer cover does not rest on the edge of the bottom dish. The weight of the cover will cause cover ridge to settle somewhat into the medium, and it is used for culturing or organism that is impossible with the thioglycolate broth as well as by pyrogallol method. So that is all about anaerobic cultural methods. Now let's see what are the questions seen in the question paper. Write note on anaerobic cultural methods for 5 marks. Write short note of anaerobic jars 2 as well as 5 marks. Write an essay on cultural methods as a general. So in that we have to mention both aerobic as well as anaerobic cultural methods. And write a note on gas pack for 2 marks. And write on a note on McIntosh field anaerobic jar for 5 marks. So hope it is clear. Thank you for watching this video.